I was really keen to share with Numberphile viewers a discovery that I made, which I was really surprised by. I'm sure everyone out there has grown up on these numbers, the Fibonacci numbers. 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13. You know, what more can there be to say about these numbers? They appear all over nature. Cut an apple open, a five-pointed star, Fibonacci number, number of petals on a flower. And, you know, Fibonacci made them famous by writing about their occurrence in nature. But it turns out they really shouldn't be called the Fibonacci numbers, because Fibonacci was not the first to discover these numbers. In fact, they were first discovered not by mathematicians or scientists at all, but by musicians and poets in India. So how did poets and musicians discover these numbers? A tabla player playing on a drum was quite interested to make as many complex rhythms as possible. What are the sort of rhythms you can make out of, say, a long beat or a short beat? Let's just take rhythm of length 4, and I could do 4 short beats. I could go, or I could do 2 long beats. So a long beat is twice a short beat. So it could just go, and that fits in our kind of length 4. But I can mix those up. So I could do short, short, long, short, long, short, or long, short, short. Now, if you explore that, that's all you can do with kind of a length 4 rhythm with long and short beats. And there turn out to be 5 of those, if you counted them. So 5 different rhythms you can make with these long and short beats. So a tabla player would like to really mix this up and might be interested, okay, with a length 16 rhythm, how many different rhythms can I make with long and short beats? And as they started to count the number of different rhythms as the rhythm gets longer, they discovered that it was these Fibonacci numbers that counted them. So if I have a rhythm of length 5, you'll find that there are 8 different rhythms I can make, starting with 5 short beats or long, long, short. The different combinations are 8. And actually, you can really see why the Fibonacci rule, remember what it is, add the 2 previous numbers to get the next number in the sequence, why this helps you to generate the new rhythms. Because suppose I want to generate those rhythms of length 5. Well, I could take the rhythms of length 4 and add a short beat to those. Or I could take the rhythms of length 3 and add a long beat to those. That would be a rhythm now of length 5. The number of combinations to make rhythms of length 5 are the ones of length 4 with a short beat on, or the ones with length 3 with a long beat on. So that's why adding the 2 previous number of rhythms together gives you the next one in the sequence. So these were discovered by these musicians. Poets also interested in lines of poetry with long and short beats. And so these numbers were actually already being talked about in India several hundred years before Fibonacci came across them. Indeed, there's an Indian poet, Hamachandra, who talks about these numbers. So frankly, they really should be called the Hamachandra numbers and not the Fibonacci numbers at all.
Did Fibonacci give a nod to the Indians or not?
I don't think actually Fibonacci would necessarily have been aware of the fact that these numbers were in rhythms. I'm sure he would have talked about it had he realized that. Fibonacci actually, of course, learned about a lot of the ideas of India and the Arabs because he spent time in Northern Africa. That's why he wrote Liberabaci. He discovered these extraordinary ideas that were bubbling up in the Arab world, and he brought them to Europe with that first book. He could have been exposed to them, but I'm sure he would have talked about that. There's another interesting way actually to think about that long and short beats, which is kind of a practical challenge you can try at home, actually, which is, you know, if you've got a set of stairs in your house, how many different ways are there to climb to the top of the stairs if you take 1 step or 2 steps at a time? So you could do each 1 step individually, or you could do it in 2 steps, and maybe you have to add an odd one in if you've got an odd number of stairs. But it's the same challenge. The number of different ways to get from the bottom of the stairs to the top, if you're either taking 1 or 2 steps at a time, is exactly the same challenge of the long and short beats rhythms. Actually, the Fibonacci numbers are started from poetry and music. And actually in the modern age, they've actually had a kind of resurgence in poetry because there's a new poetic form which uses the Fibonacci numbers for its structure. And it's something called a fib. So in England, a fib is a lie, but in this case, it's a sort of poetry. And this poet, Gregory Pincus, came up with this idea of, actually, why don't we use the Fibonacci numbers to kind of give a structure for a poem? So his idea was each line of the poem should have the number of syllables of that Fibonacci number. So it should start one syllable, two syllables, three syllables, five, eight, and so on. And he felt just in the same way as Fibonacci discovered there was a sense of growth that connects these numbers, that when you read a poem with these Fibonacci rhythms, there's a kind of naturalness to it. And so here was Gregory Pincus's first fib. And you can probably hear just the kind of nice way the Fibonacci helped build up a sort of a poetic structure. One small, precise, poetic, spiraling mixture, math plus poetry yields the fib. Rather beautiful. So I thought actually I would offer my Twitter followers a challenge because I thought it's kind of a nice, small, tight form Twitter, perfect place to write your own fib. And so I offered this challenge out to my followers and I got a wonderful load of fibs back, but I've chosen my favorite for you because I think it's rather beautiful. It was by @BenBush. Tweet, tweet, Marcus, here's my fib. An unwise ad lib. Wait, fib on Twitter? I'm confused. How many of my 140 have I used? Which is pretty cool, and you might also notice 140, so it was the move to 280, which actually probably has the same number of syllables, it might still work. But I think it's rather nice because he's gone 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8. He actually got to 13 in his fib, which is pretty impressive. After that, it starts to not sound like poetry and sounds more like sort of prose. So that's where I think you've got to stop.
All right, Marcus, can I throw the same challenge to the YouTube commenters on this video?
I think I'd love to see all the fibs that are going to appear at the bottom of this little Numberphile video.
Well watched. What next? Links to click? Well, we have plenty. See the video description for books by Marcus and other stuff that you should see.
Here we see sort of symmetry, playing the two together to generate music. His artistry really is being able to write a piece of music, then apply a little bit of mathematics to it, to create something that together makes something beautifully harmonic and complex.
Professor, not being a musician, I have no clue by looking at that.